Good morning, Ian with IBC Technologies. Just showing you the initial setup for an SL G3 residential boiler. When you power up the boiler, you will be given an express site setting screen. And here you can make a few choices, either to choose imperial or metric units, to enter the design outdoor temperature for your region, the detected altitude, and it gives you a chance to set the clock on the boiler. Once you have entered those values, you can go to next. You will then be given a list of four loads, all of which will have an off sign next to them. If you touch load 1, you'll then get an option to either choose the load as a reset heating load, which is using the outdoor sensor on the boiler to determine a variable set point, or a set point load where you can set a fixed set point for the boiler to run at, a DHW load, which is for running a hot water, indirect hot water tank, and then external control if you are pairing the boiler to a BMS building management system and want to run the boiler on a 0 to 10 input. Your last option is a zone of if you want to run two loads, where one load is a zone of an original load. Let's choose set point for this load, and then we can input the boiler supply we want, let's say 130 Fahrenheit or a radiant floor, our maximum supply, which has to be 10 to 15 degrees higher than our boiler supply set point, a summer shutdown value can be entered, and we can choose whether we are going to have this run as a high priority load or a medium, low, or very low. In this case, I'm going to set it as a very low, and once I have finished that, I can also enter a pump post purge time in seconds, which will allow the pump for that particular load to run for a certain time after the call for heat. I then push save, and I will go on to my next load. Let's say load 2, and here I'm going to choose DHW for domestic hot water tank. I'm going to set the set point for the actual tank if I'm using a 10 k-ohm sensor, then the boiler supply to the tank, which in this case is set for 170 Fahrenheit, my maximum set to 190, and I'm going to set the priority for very high. The pump post purge I've set for 180 seconds, and the boiler pump is set to on. If you are piping the domestic tank out one side of the boiler with its own dedicated tank and pump, and it is not part of the primary loop, you can set that boiler pump to off and OK. Once this is complete, you will get a warning to say that the load pump must provide adequate flow through the boiler heat exchanger for this load. We say yes and close and save. This would be a typical setup for a residential boiler, and once we have completed, we can then go back and back again, and the boiler will then come up with a front screen. All we have to do then is create a call for heat on load 1, which is number 5 and 6 on the TB2 terminal, and the set point load on this particular boiler will become active at 130 Fahrenheit.